Hello, everyone. How are you doing? Are you enjoying the Global Azure Virtual 2020? I hope that this event continues to be a great learning experience for you. My name is Luis Beltran, and today I'm going to teach you how to create an image classifier with Azure Custom Vision .NET SDK. Let's get started. Very quickly, allow me to introduce myself. I am Luis, a Mexican Microsoft MVP who works as a researcher at Tomás Batlle University in Slin, Czech Republic. I'm also a lecturer at Tecnológico Nacional de México in Celaya, Mexico. And everything related with Xamarin Mobile Applications, Azure Cloud Computing, and Artificial Intelligence attracts my interest. Back to the topic, this is the outline of my presentation. Firstly, let's talk about image classification. What is it, and how is it perceived by humans? Then, we will move on to Azure Cognitive Services and how AI is simplified for us. The third and final topic is the Custom Vision service, and we will go through and explore it to understand how to create a mobile application that recognizes images by using a previously trained smart model. By the way, you can download this presentation by clicking on the link that appears in this slide. All right, then. What is image classification? Well, simply put, it means to identify the visual content in a picture, such as recognizing that there is a dog in the first image and a cat in the second one. In a more scientific way, the human eye perceives an image as a set of signals that are processed by the visual cortex in the brain. This results in a vivid experience of a scene associated with concepts and objects recorded in our memory. It is actually a very trivial task for us humans. However, for software and computers, it is quite the opposite, as this interesting topic in artificial intelligence and computer vision actually builds a model, most of the time by implementing a neural network or even a convolutional neural network, which is part of the deep learning techniques. As you know, the image is a sequence of bytes, and these values are put in arrays. Depending on the AI algorithm, the array is processed several times, but the idea remains. The objective is to extract patterns and features that are unique to a specific object, let's say a cat, several times. And then the neural network can build a model that can identify cats in an image in another different image. This extraction task is repeated several times and using more than one image in order to build a strong model that can recognize a specific object with high accuracy. If you want to improve your classifier and let it recognize, let's say, also dogs, then you need to provide pictures that contain dogs and retrain your model so it can identify both animals in images. So the question is, do we actually need to be an AI expert or proficient in mathematics or data science in order to develop software that can recognize objects? Well, thanks to Azure, this complex task is easier to enter cognitive services, which are a suit of APIs that allow you to easily integrate vision, speech, language, and knowledge capabilities in your application. Let's say that you have a letter, you take a photo of it, and you would like an application to read it loud for you. Well, you can use the OCR capability that is included in the computer vision service. Simply send an image to a resource that is hosted on Azure of the text in the picture. It will be analyzed by the service and the text will be extracted for you. You can get details such as the position or location of this message in the picture of every word. And there are other capabilities such as converting your voice into text or the opposite, building a bot while understanding your customers with natural language, and smart search using Bing. And no AI knowledge is required because everything translates to API requests and responses in your code. So you can quickly integrate the process of smart functionalities in your applications. Even further, each service provides an SDK which is available in several platforms, such as .NET, Node.js, Python, Go, and other frameworks and platforms in order to accelerate your development. Computer vision, as we saw, is one of these cognitive services that allows you to embed vision capabilities in your applications. You send a picture to the service and you can get a description of what's inside as a response. You can also extract printed and handwritten text, recognize logos, brands, and even landmarks. Or what about content moderation? That is also possible with computer vision. And there are many more functionalities that are waiting for you. But sometimes you would like to recognize only specific items that are part of your business process or scenario. And this is where custom vision can be useful. In this case, you need to follow a machine learning approach by training a model with tagged images, but of course, no expertise in AI is required. How does it work? Well, there are some steps that you need to follow in order to build a custom vision model that recognizes specific objects. First, you need to create a project that will be hosted on Azure. Concepts such as image classification, object detection, and domains take relevance here. We will explain them in a minute. After the project is created, you submit images and add tags that identify them. With these labeled images, you can train a classifier, and in a matter of minutes, you will get an intelligent API that can be integrated in your solutions in order to identify elements of importance in newer images that are sent from your applications to the service. You can use the portal or an SDK to create your image classifier. For this talk, I will focus on the .NET SDK, but if you are a Python, Java, Node.js, or Go developer, Microsoft has got you covered for any other language with no SDK support. You can also use the request to the API. The .NET SDK is contained in two NuGet packages, Microsoft Azure Computer Cognitive Services, Vision, Custom Vision Prediction, and the same one, but with training. After we add them into our project, we can immediately start using them by including them in our namespaces or codes, as you can see in the lower image. No other configuration is needed. So, as we mentioned earlier, the first step into creating an image classifier is to start with a project, create a project, which represents the data and model for a specific task. An image classifier is a model built with custom vision service using tagged images. So it is safe to assume that a project is basically an image classifier. So we can use both terms as synonyms in this talk. We must create the project from the portal. Basic information is required at the beginning, such as the name of our image classifier, a description, an Azure resource, which in turn asks for subscription, resource group, location, and pricing tier. The usual stuff that you need when you set up an Azure resource. The project also needs to know if it will be performing either image classification or object detection tasks. They are different problems, since the image classifier just recognizes elements within a picture, while the object detector, as you can see in this other slide, also returns the position of the element inside the image. In the form of enclosing rectangles or squares determined by top and left coordinates with a width and height values. These are returned as part of the response. So, back to our project creation. After you choose the project type, you can also select between multi-label or multi-class. This means that you can select if your images contain one or more tags per picture. So how many things an object can be? So is either multi-label or multi-class classification type. Imagine that you have a picture with a cat inside, and let's say we add the tag cat. If there is only one tag in this image and the other images, this is a multi-class problem. But if only with this picture we add several labels, just as such as cat, animal, friendly, and any others, this is a multi-label scenario. So it depends on the problem that you want to solve. Selecting a domain is also part of the project creation process. The domain optimizes the classifier by reducing the set of possible objects that can be identified in the images. There are three domains that you can choose from. Food, which is optimized for dishes that you will see on a restaurant menu, for instance, or vegetable drinks, apples, fruits. Yeah, if you want to identify objects within this domain. The second one is landmark, which is a domain ideal for landscapes, buildings, for instance. In other words, recognizable landmarks, so both natural and artificial. And the third one is a retail, which is useful for shopping websites where you would like to identify products or distinguish in a shopping catalog, for instance. In case that your images don't belong to any of these domains, you can also use the general one. So, as you can see, these are the four domains. The general contains all the possible images. So it's like your latest option if your image doesn't fit in any of these domains. And by the way, you can see that there are also compact versions of every domain that we just mentioned. These compact versions are particularly useful when you would like to export your trainer model and use it in mobile applications. A compact model is a lightweight version that is faster. It's perfect for mobile platforms or devices, but the accuracy is decreased a bit. So it's up to you if you would like to sacrifice a bit of accuracy, but on the other hand, you will get the results faster. Remember that in mobile applications, life battery and CPU processing are important. So we select the domain and also the export capabilities, and we just simply click on the Create Project button, and we will have a basic Azure resource that we will work with in the next part. So the project is created. We can head to settings and get three important elements. The project key, which is used for billing purposes. The endpoint, where all our requests will be sent. And the resource ID, which will be used later when we get to the publication. This information, these three elements, are used in our application. And the SDK allows us to create a custom vision training client in the very first step. Requires both the API and the endpoint that we obtain from the settings. Of get projects async, we can get to the list of projects associated with our account. But in this case, we only need a specific project, which is this one, Coil 100 small. And this name was set a few minutes ago when we decided the name of our project. So we just simply use LinkU, for example, to query and get this the reference to this specific project from the list. And we can continue. Images, of course, are the most important pieces in the classifier. Several training images are required by the custom vision service, so a high precision classifier can be created from. What's a training image? Well, simply put, it is a picture of the image that you assign a tag that you would like the service to extract the features in order to build the classifier. So if we go back to our code or project, we have, for example, a set of tags. In this case, I have a dictionary. So you can see some products, some elements. We add each of these tags or elements from our dictionary. We add them to the project with the create tag async method from our training client object. In order to verify if a tag exists before trying to add them to the project, the get tags async can be used. This method returns the list of tags that are found in our project, and it is important because we can get an error if we would like to add a tag that exists before. So rather than trying to duplicate our tags, we can obtain the number of images that are included in this existing tag with the image count property. And now that we have the relevant tags included or added in the project, it is time to add the images. So, as you can see, we have several pictures here in our project, actually more than 1,000. We have 72 images per tag, and we have around 17, I think. Good. So, the method create images from data async allows us to upload the image. We sent every picture as a memory stream along with the specific tag for this file. As you can see, actually, it is allowed to submit a collection of tags. And if you remember, this is part of the multi-class or multi-label scenario. So if we have more than one tag in our image, it is multi-label, and we will set here, we will set here different tags. Otherwise, just one is required. And we do this process for every image. Here it's just some basic string manipulation because these images are obtained from the COIL 100 dataset, which is publicly available. But every image has this name, object, a number, and then a couple of underscores and a consecutive number. So we use the number as an identifier, and this identifier is assigned here in the dictionary. So that's how we associate the ID with the tag. But yeah, it's just a string manipulation. So now that the images have been included in our project, it is time to train the classifier. So this actually means that the cognitive service will identify patterns and extract features of the images that are labeled with a certain tag. This learning process is iterative, and the accuracy depends on the number of images per tag, the quality of the pictures, and several other factors. So it is important to provide many significant pictures, and also context matters, as you will see later in this presentation. If we use the SDK, it simply means to call the train project async method to get started. So we can check every second, what's the status of this training process with the method getIterationAsync. Until the not training status is found. So when it is finished, we will have the complete status. Or maybe if there is an error, the process will also be stopped. So we can check it after the iteration finishes, either in successful way or with an error. And after we have the trained model, we can proceed to test the last iteration with new images in order to find out if it is accurate or if it needs more training. If we see that the model is capable enough of classifying the images, we can publish it. This allows the model to be accessed either via an HTTP endpoint, through the SDK is also possible, for online image classification, or we can export it to a platform for offline image classification scenarios. Well, actually, these two actions are possible. They don't interfere with each other. So, both online and offline scenarios are supported. In the SDK, it is actually a very simple process because we just call the publish iteration async method, providing, of course, the required parameters, such as the iteration ID, the published model name that we set up at the beginning of this code, and the resource ID that we obtained when we created the model. And that's it. As we mentioned before, you can also use the prediction API. So in this case, you need to go to the portal. You can click on performance, on the performance tab, then prediction URL. And of course, you need the project to be published, let's say by the SDK or here in the portal. So you can see how to send an image to the classifier in order to get a result. If you are providing a image URL, you use these instructions. But if we are sending an image, let's say a stream or a sequence of bytes, you use this other URL, is different from the other one. The prediction key, which is actually the very first one, the same one that we obtained at the beginning when we created the project in settings. And when we make or create this HTTP request, we need to send the image as an octet stream. But of course, we can also use the SDK. So as you can see in the code, we have three test images. But now we will use a custom vision prediction client instance. Not training. Training was relevant in the previous steps, but now we are using this other object or class. So we pass an image in the form of a stream to the method classify image async. So yeah, you see here the stream, the published model name and the project ID. And as a response, we will get all the tags that are included in our project, but each one will also have an score associated with the image. Of course, the higher one represents what the classifier thinks about the picture that was sent. So if we have 15 tags, we will get a probability for each of these tags, and the maximum one represents the actual result. So we need to dig a bit. It is useful to know what's the sentiment, let's say, of the image classifier for each tag, because if we see that it is incorrect in one image, but the second closest or higher tag is the real one, it means that it needs a bit of tuning, or we need to provide more images. We need some improvement to increase this accuracy. If we see that the expected tag is quite lower in the score, it means that we actually need to either rework or train much more this classifier. So yeah, it is. That's why it is important to analyze all these results or collections. So yeah, that's most of it. But of course, we also mentioned at the beginning that the model is portable and can be exported for offline scenarios, such as a mobile application with no internet connection, or Docker containers, where your artificial intelligence models will be hosted. It is possible to deploy from Azure Cloud Custom Vision Service to the edge, and different platforms are supported, such as TensorFlow for Android and Python scenarios, CoreML for iOS applications, Onyx for Windows, WinML, Docker, and other platforms are also supported. We can export the model by using the portal. Simply click on the Performance tab, and then on Export button, and select your desired platform. Remember that you need to select the compact domain for some of these platforms to be both allowed and also optimized. So it is up to you. Moreover, we can also export these models to several platforms with the SDK. We need to use, again, our training custom vision client object. And we will use the export iteration async method. In this case, it requires the iteration ID, but also the platform name, such as TensorFlow, as you can see in this example. It takes some time for the model to be exported. So we can check that with the get exports async method. We will get a collection of all the previous platforms, or sorry, of all the previous exports that have been made of this iteration. So, if so, just obtain the reference to this specific object. And after this task is completed, you simply need to use the download URI property to from the export object. This is the export object. In order to, of course, download or retrieve the model in the corresponding file format. So it's quite easy. So let's go to the demo and check the result. This project is a .NET Core console application written in C# that is available as an open source project in my GitHub repository. So in order for this project to work, you will need to create the project in Custom Vision, of course. So first of all, let's go to the portal. And you can see that this image classifier or project is empty. No images, no tags, no iterations, no nothing. This is the code of the application that we described through the slides. You can see everything here. Also, we included the 1,000 images in our project, along with some test pictures. So let's run this program. And you can see first that the project information is obtained in this part. The project was found, then the tags that were added or created. And after that, all the images are being added or uploaded into the project. So yeah, of course, this will take some time. So let's simply wait. After all the images have been added, you can see the beginning of the training process. So it is being checked every second. When it is finished, you can see that the model is published and then evaluated with 3 test images. So image number 2 was detected as an onion. We can check it here. Yes, it is an onion. Next picture. It is a frog. And our classifier for image number 4, it says, yes, it is a frog. And for image 5, it is a cigarette box. It is the top one. So let's see if that's true. Yes, it is there. So after that, we can see that the project is now asking us if we would like to export the model. So let's give it a go. Let's now choose TensorFlow, for instance. So the process will start. We wait a few seconds. And yeah, it says that we can find the downloaded model in this path. We will check it later. Now let's try Core ML. Again, the process takes a while. Then it finishes. And we can say, OK, this is enough. Those are the platforms that I want. So let's finish this program. So now, if we go to the path that was mentioned in the program, we can see these two elements, the model and also the TensorFlow one. So we have these files, and we can take both files and put them in a mobile application for offline scenarios in Android and iOS devices. Actually, that's our next demo. Image classification with custom vision and Xamarin. This application allows both online and offline scenarios. For online, we send a request to the prediction API. While for offline, we use the exported TensorFlow and CoreML packages. Again, this project is open source. Simply go to my GitHub repository and download it. So let's take a look and see how it works. So this is our mobile application. Let's explore the offline part. In this case, we created the Custom Vision Local Service class. We are using the on-device Custom Vision plugin, which simplifies things a bit. So here we use the classify image method. Yes, we include a stream of the picture that we ask the user to send. And from the collection of predictions, we sort them by probability. And we get the top tag, which is the prediction from our classifier. In order for this on-device custom vision plugin to work, we need to add in our Android project, for instance, the TensorFlow model. If we check the exported platforms from our previous project, we see here that the TensorFlow exported file is a zip one. And inside, there is this model and also the labels. Of course, the label includes all the tags that are detected by the service. And this model is the TensorFlow one. So we just simply add it as part of the assets from our application. In the main activity, we indicate to our image classifier that these two elements contain the custom vision service exported. iOS application is more or less the same. In this case, it accepts an ML model. And in the app delegate, we prepare the project to understand this model. So here we include this resource, also the extension, and it needs to be compiled. So now let's run the application. That's all we need. The rest is just the views, but we will explore it when we see the application. But if you want to create an offline image classifier, you just need to add the plugin, prepare in the specific platforms, and the rest is just to set up the views, the view model, call them method, and that's it. But let's see. So in this case, we will select a picture that is in our device. Let's say, let's select this one. And let's analyze in local with the local API. Yes, and we see the result is a frog. Let's take a look at different images. Of course, we can only provide images that are, let's say, from our tags. I mean, they can be different images. Of course, we use images that were not included in the training set. They are different, but they are part of the tags. In this case, we didn't include a known tag. So all everything else is assigned to this known tag. So yeah, you see that in this case, it is accurate. Maybe the precision is not too high, but remember that this is a compact export platform, which is accurate, not at all, but it is faster. Yes. So we can also check how it works for iOS device in local scenario. It's the very same project. Now let's select a third image. This one. Let's use the local model, and you can see, yeah, it is detected as an onion, and the result was really, really fast. So what happens with the online part? In this case, we prepared a Custom Vision Azure service class. As you can see, we need to prepare also an HTTP client instance. We are using a prediction URL that we learned in the slides. We knew that we have to use that prediction base. We have also the key and the project request. I split actually the URL in this base URL and also project request. But yeah, this is the full. They both are the full URL. So back to this class, we send the image as a stream. And something that is important and not mentioned in the documentation, it is not updated, is that now you need to secure all your requests by using the TLS-12 protocol, security protocol. So yeah, just simply add this, and you are good to go. We also indicate that this is an octet stream, as was mentioned before. And similar to the local scenario, we obtain a collection of predictions. We simply go with the highest one. Yes, we order by. And yeah, if this probability is higher than 0.5, it is part of our labels. Otherwise, it is not described yet. So we can do more or less the same. Let's try with this image. And now let's use the cloud service. It takes a while, and yeah, it says that it is a frog. So yeah, let's see what happens if I use a picture of a person. We shouldn't get a tag with a higher accuracy. Let's say that for every tag, actually, we can maybe see it here. Let's say these are all our predictions, 17 tags, and each one should get a low score. Let's say, well, in this case, the highest one, it says 42%, but not too accurate. It's a toy tank. And the rest are with lower scores, 0.25, So this is some kind of validation, even though we didn't consider a known tag. So yeah, for the local scenario, we could also include this validation and say, okay, this element is not part of any of the knowledge that I have. And yeah, that's it. And as I said, the rest is just summary code. This is view model. And every click of these images or tag items, the actions are represented here. This is take photo. You can also use the camera. In this case, since this is a simulator, yeah, we cannot use the camera, but in real device, this will work. And for classification, we have these two. You have the remote or Azure and the local one. And the method is the same, just depending on the parameter, it will call the local or the Azure one. And yeah, this is just the interface, very, very simple. And that's basically it. Let's go back to our presentation. Final thoughts of this presentation. First of all, let's explore a bit of optimization. Adding a diversity of labeled images, including different backgrounds, angles, object sizes, groups of photos, and variants of types, definitely helps the classifier and boosts your chances of generating a top quality one. Consider including images that truly represent what your classifier will encounter in the real world. This means that photos in context are better than photos of objects in front of neutral backgrounds. If the target images that you will find in real life are in darker places, but you train your model with, let's say, full light, most probably your classifier won't be accurate. Each time that you add new images also, it is recommended to train your model so it can consider these new elements. Remember that you can retrain your model with the feedback that your users give. If they found that some pictures or elements were misclassified, you can improve always your classifier, but you need to train and publish to obtain this improved or optimized classifier. And finally, there is also a recommendation to use at least 30 images per tag in order to improve your classifier. What about pricing? Well, Custom Vision Service has two tiers. The free one allows you 2 transactions per second, create up to 2 projects, and make 10,000 predictions per month at no cost, among other characteristics. For production scenarios, you can consider the standard tier, which allows you to increase the number of transactions per second up to 10, create 100 projects, and upload larger images in size. The service considers 3 elements for billing purposes: the number of requests, the processing time, and the storage. Here you can see some scenarios where Custom Vision can be applied, such as in a production line to categorize each item and send it to the correct part. Also, you can use Custom Vision to identify unhealthy plants, or maybe you have a shop and you can use the system or build a system that assists customers When they would like to find the price of a specific object, they place it in front of the camera. The application recognizes the item, and then the description or detailed information is shown to the user. Of course, there are also other scenarios, so the sky is the limit. Finally, here you have some resources that you can use to get started in this amazing world of custom vision. I encourage you to try the service and make the most of it in your applications. Integrations are easy, as you just saw in this presentation. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for your attention. And also, thanks to the organizers of the Virtual Azure Global for having me. It was a pleasure to be here this hour with you and talk about artificial intelligence and how we, as developers, can build smart applications that are able to solve businesses' needs with the power of computer vision. My name is Luis Beltrán, and if you want to connect, simply drop me an email. I would be glad to help you. Follow me on Twitter for Xamarin and Azure-related posts, and you can also check my LinkedIn and previous project on my GitHub repository. See you next time, and enjoy the rest of the Global Azure Virtual Edition 2020. Goodbye, and have a nice day.